Hi everybody, welcome along to this festive special. Before we get into it, I just want to say thanks very much to everybody that's listened, watched, shared, downloaded, commented, messaged me. It's really, really appreciated, and long may it continue. So just to wish you all a very happy Christmas and a great new year. Let's hope 2023 is a good one. This is a short clip from a couple of years ago. I was privileged to be joined by the wonderful Steve White as a co-host, and we spoke to Don Powell from Slade, and Steve asked the question about the famous Slade song. You all know which one that is, and I hope you enjoy this little snippet of our conversation. It kind of fits in with the festive period, so enjoy, have a great Christmas, see you soon.
So what's it like come September, walking into a garage, a pub, a restaurant, or turning on the telly and hearing the tune? How do you feel about that?
We call it that record.
Yeah,
that record. It's amazing. I mean, you know what it's like yourself, Sim, but we've had 24 hits on People Only Remember That One. I'm proud of it, but tell you what, there's some funny things happen. I remember we were on tour one time in England, and I was in the elevator, and I was in the front. I got my back to everybody. Of course, it was playing in the system. The record was playing in the lift, you know, and I'm just standing there. And whether he did it on purpose, his bloke behind me said, "Oh, I'm very fed up with this record." and I just turned around and looked at him, you know. And the same was in a supermarket, you know, the same thing. I was at the till paying for me groceries or whatever it was, and it was playing over the system, and the young girl behind the counter was singing as loud as she could over it. Then she looked at me, she went blood red, said, oh, it's him. It was great. I mean, it is funny though. I mean, it's great. I mean, when you think that was done in 73.
Yeah. And wasn't it recorded in New York?
New York in the summer of 73, we were on a world tour at the time. We just finished an American tour. We had a week off before we went to Australia. And so we had like, we said, well, we'll just stay in New York for the week, say, coming back to England, then coming all the way back again to Australia. And Chaz was great like this. He said to Nod and Jim, do you have any songs while we're here? And they said, we've got this Christmas song. And Chaz was great. He see his eyes light up. He says, great, I'm going to book the studio. He said, because if it works, we're going to, we have to get it done now and send back to England. But if you listen to that record is a total overdub. I think the only thing that was kept from the basic track run through was the bass drum. We overdubbed everything else. And if you listen very, you'll know what I mean, Stephen. If you listen right at the very end, because I put the snare drum on again afterwards, and I forgot to stop, you can just hear one tap as the record finished, you know. But you've got to listen to it, because I didn't know the song that well, you know, because I was just talking about the amnesia thing, and you can just hear one snare drum tap, and I didn't come off the drums at the right time.
I can just...
It's a total overdub, that record.
I can just see everyone who's watching this now going to put the song on to listen. Yeah. Headphones on.
You've got to listen to it hard, but there's just one snare drum tap extra over the top. But I mean, I think I didn't talk about this last time we spoke. We didn't want to release it.
No, you didn't. You didn't say.
We didn't get to. No,
the band. We didn't want to release it. We said nah. No, we ain't sure. I mean, you've probably been through that yourself, Stephen. We said, no, we ain't sure. We don't know what, we're not really sure about it. I mean, Charles was great. I said, I don't care what you lot say. This is coming out. You know, I mean, glad. I mean, it was just phenomenal, that thing. You know, I mean, just even now, I mean, it's just unbelievable. I mean, I got the platinum record for it now, but it went gold the first day of release when it came out, because it was just unbelievable. I mean, everywhere you went, that record, you know, sort of thing. But like I said, we had 24 hits and people don't remember that one.
can I ask, Don, would you have put that in your set regardless of the time of the year, or did you keep it?
Yes. But I tell you what, sometimes, you know, Matthew, it was in the contract that we had to play that song. You know, we had to finish with it. We couldn't put it anywhere else in the set because we couldn't follow it. And And that was it. It was in the contract sometimes that we had to do that song, you know, at the end, you know. But it's great. It's what it was. You know, I mean, it's funny when we felt when it's in the height of the summer. And now we are singing about Christmas, you know. So
you've got about another 5 weeks, and you'll start hearing it again.
That's it. I'll be waiting for it. You know, it's great. But it's good. It's good laugh. I mean, not in the for me. It's like. I mean, you think how old? I mean, 73, for God's sake. And but it was great. It was a great time. Great time.
It'll never age. It'll never age, will it?
No, it'll be there forever. The thing was, I mean, you probably had this as well, Stephen. That year we had four hits. It was "Come On, Feel the Noise," "Squeeze Me, Please Me," went in at number one the first day release, and then the record "My Friend Stan" after that went in at number four, and people were saying we were finished. You know, I mean, yeah, give me a break, come on. Some people are so quick and knock you off that pedestal.
Totally, it's unbelievable.
That was a great year, that was.